students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the roadmap after Dehradun written by Gopal Krishna Gandhi. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for public administration and political science optional students. Now this editorial is about the role that a speaker should be playing, a role that a president should be playing, a role that a governor should be playing. And this editorial is also about how these three offices, the office of governor, speaker and president, they should be working and exhibiting their role in an ethical manner so that the polity of India can be conducted in a sacramental and a sagacious manner. Now, when we look at the role of President of India, now the President of India, he works as per the principles, as per the laws, as per the ethos of parliamentary form of government. Now what is parliamentary form of government? Now parliamentary form of government is a type of government in which the president has to actually act on the aid and the advice of the council of ministers. Now the people, they elect the member of parliament. Now these member of parliament, they actually form the government. In a parliamentary form of government, it is the responsibility of the council of the ministers to run the government. And this responsibility is conferred by the people onto these council of ministers. So it is practical, it is logical, and it is rational for these council of ministers to get their work done. Now how can their work be done? Their work is performed through the office of the president. Now why the work is performed through the office of the president? It is performed because along with the parliamentary form of government, we have also chosen the system of a republican form of the government, whereby the president is representing the government and that India is a sovereign country. So it is the responsibility of the council of ministers to run the country. Now by this logic, is it right or is it ethical on the part of council of ministers to get whatever work they want to be done through the president? No, this is not right, because if they will be doing that, it will be going against the ethos and the vision of the Constitution of India. Now the Constitution of India has put up a lot of responsibility on the shoulders of president. It is the president of India that has to upheld the consigns of the constitution. Now this is also pledged in the oath of the president. He has to take a pledge that he will be upholding the oath of the constitution. Now along with the parliamentary form of government, we also have a quasi-federal system in which the central government is more strong, and this is being used in order to topple the governments at the state level. But in SR Bumai case, Supreme Court, it has come out with very firm guidelines and rules of how a government at the state level can be done away with. How can the president's rule under 356 can be imposed over the states? In SR Bumai case, Supreme Court has put their premium onto the conductance of the flow test. Now, according to Supreme Court, this flow test is the most important thing. And before a president imposes a president's rule on the recommendation of the cabinet or of the council of ministers, president must ascertain of whether the flow test was done or not, or the sufficient opportunity was provided to the government in order to justify their majority or not, whether they were given enough leeway or not. Now, these things have to be ascertained by the president. Now, the tacit, the implicit and indirect powers have been conferred onto the office of president in India by the Supreme Court's verdict in the SR Bhumei case. SR Bhumei case ne ek responsibility dal diya hai president ke upar, and the president must not act as a rubber stamp. He must act as a protector. He must act as a vigilant one to protect the constitutions from the transgressions, from the whims and fancies of the central government. Now, this editorial has given certain examples, like how Venkataraman, he was actually a silent and spectacular president, and how K.R. Narayanan has performed his role with a lot of alacrity. So, the ultimate test is the test of the personality of a president, of how he or she conducts the role in upholding the constitution of India. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.